Howdy do, folks. This here's the old mountain man talking at you from the backside of this here lake in the hills of Arkansas. Well, y'all know how I improvise sometimes. I'll take something that's broke down and its original purpose, it just don't want to function no more for its original purpose, so I reuse it, I modify it, what have you. Well, this time I just stripped away what I didn't need off of something and using it for a totally different purpose. And what I'm calling it is the world's biggest improvised cigarette lighter. Ta-da! Yeah. That's what it is. The world's biggest improvised cigarette lighter. The flame's not real big. See right there, you can kind of see that. The flame doesn't get up real big. It could be used for an emergency fire starter, blah, 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 whatever you could use a flame for. And it's got that. It used to be, excuse me for a second. I need my coffee. This cold air outside here. Cold air and smokers' lungs do not go together. Quick health fact. Smokers cough more in the wintertime than they do in the summertime. Because the cold air constricts the lungs and draws them up. Just pretty much like it does everything else. Now getting back to the improvised world's biggest cigarette lighter. It was a Mr. Heater little buddy home, you know, space heater type thing, propane fueled, of course. But it just quit working for its original purpose. There was something wrong with that little proximity sensor. You know, if a heater, modern heater these days, tilts the wrong way, this way or that, it will just shut off. It's got a cutoff sensor in there. Well, this thing, it just wouldn't light. It just wouldn't light anymore. So I went and just took everything off of it. I made sure to check for leaks. After I was done, I tightened everything up that needed to be tightened up, which was just this little thing right here. And the only thing this thing controls is the movement of this little switch right here, which impacts the spark. You know, this little thing right here, the little electric ignition. Kind of sort of see that in the wind there. But as you can probably tell also, I'm shooting in a higher quality video. Video format, 720p. I'm using a laptop that a dear friend sent to me, my buddy Mario Martins. Thank you very much, Mario. I finally, not too swift on the uptake sometimes, and I was thinking about video quality, and that my subscribers, now that I've got like 568 of them, deserve a lot better. And as you can pretty well see, the sun has got the clouds blowing away from it. It's cold as a well digger's ass in Iceland, but you know, I'm gonna kind of lean back here. Get that glare off of me. I don't know what YouTube is going to do with this, if they're going to convert it to 240p or 480p, but I'm shooting in 720p, and I know I've seen movies where on YouTube where they titled it as being in 1080p, and it turned out to be 240p, which the P stands for pixels. The higher pixel count, the higher quality of the video, or photo, whichever. Background, I don't know about those trees back there, look a little blurry to me. And I'm going to have to work on the contrast. Hello, little bear. Yeah. Every single time. Okay. Hey, you wanted attention. Pay attention to the weenie dog next door. Little bear. Look over here. Look over here. Say hi to everybody. Not him. Oh, boy. That's my dog. Big old baby. It looks like I'm talking to somebody else. And by golly, he's right there. Well, folks, I'm going to end this here video. And just remind you, just because it doesn't serve its original purpose anymore, or quits functioning for its original purpose, it can't. Some things can be salvaged, improvised, and have the useless parts stripped away. And you could come up with something like this. Just be careful what you loosen up. And, you know, pay attention to all those fittings and everything. Make sure not to loosen them up. And as you, as y'all folks will be able to hear in the background, yeah. Anyway, for now, this is the Old Mountain Man signing off from the backside of this here lake in the hills of Arkansas. Wishing y'all a good evening, and since it is 4:42 p.m. Central Standard Time here in the United States. And as I always say, try to always be good to yourselves and try to be good to each other. Of course, I say try to be good to each other because some people just won't let you be good to them. We'll talk to y'all later. Take care. Be good.